How to evolve Pokemon inside of Pokemon Masters. What is up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, and today we're going to be going over exactly how to evolve Pokemon in Pokemon Masters. I'm going to be very quick, short, to the point, because it's a very simple thing. But again, the game doesn't do that much in explaining how to, at least from my knowledge anyway, because I've been skipping a lot of the story stuff and just been grinding and just been, you know, loving the battle aspect of this game. I haven't been paying too much attention to the story, but again, very addicting. I'm all over this game, and again, it was something that I had to question myself on, like, how the hell do you do this? And then I basically figured it out. Now I'm doing this video for you just to help out anybody I can. Again, in order to evolve any Pokemon, you're going to need, first, obviously, a sync pair Pokemon that can evolve. I believe there's 6 of them. I'm going to have them listed here on the screen just in case you need to check out which Pokemon, if you don't know for whatever reason, which Pokemon does evolve. For this video, I'm going to be using Price's Pokemon Seal because that was one of the first trainers I pulled, and Seal evolves into Dewgong, and it was one of the first Pokemon that I evolved in the game. But I do know, because of the story, you do get Rosa very early on as well. So I'm going to be showing through her eyes as well, just in case if that's going to be the person that you're trying to evolve, because that might be the only Pokemon that you have that can evolve. So what you want to do first is actually level up that sync pair to level 30. Level 30 should be the level cap for whatever trainer that you have currently, especially in the beginning of the game. What you want to do is just grind up to level 30. It's very easy to grind in this game. You can redo missions, or you can go to the training area and go to a level up course. It is the first tab you're gonna see, and do the beginner, do the normal, and do the hard courses over and over and over again until your Pokemon is at top level. You also can use an in-game item inside of the teams tab and go to level up, where you can use these level up manuals, which gives your Pokemon experience points, which help them to level up. So once you have your Pokemon to level 30, your sync pair anyway to level 30, what you want to do is go to the Pokemart inside of the main lobby of the game. Go to exchange items inside of the shop. Now don't worry, you do not have to actually purchase stuff with real world money. You can use all the in-game coins that you have. And then on the top, I believe on the top, is going to say evolutionary crystals. You use those to evolve your Pokemon. You need to use 5 crystals to unlock the first evolution, and I believe it's 10 or 15, I could be wrong, on the second evolution if you have a Pokemon that evolves later on at level 45. So you get these evolutionary crystals, and then you go to sync pair stories. In sync pair stories, what you're going to do is look for the person that you want to evolve, obviously. You click on them, and then underneath a day with the person, you're going to see their Pokemon and the evolution. You click it, it's gonna jump to a battle screen directly where you have to battle a person. It will give the person's type, and you will notice that you cannot change out that specific Pokemon. You only can use that Pokemon as a one-on-one battle, and you have to win. If you win, your Pokemon will evolve at the end of the battle as a reward. If you lose, don't worry, you get kicked out of the match, but you keep your crystals so you can retry either with a different Pokemon if you're trying to evolve a different Pokemon, or you could retry with the same Pokemon. You will keep the 5 crystals that you spent to enter in the match. So again, you're not really losing anything for trying. And that's it. You know, that's pretty much it. Again, it's something that they don't really explain too well inside of Pokemon Masters. And again, I could be wrong. Maybe I just skipped over it. But it was something I was wondering the first couple of hours of playing Pokemon Masters. And then once I figured out that they sell those crystals, and I was trying to figure out where to use those crystals, I was like, oh, okay, I kind of see what's going on here. And then boom, put 1, 2, 3 together. That's exactly how you evolve Pokemon and Pokemon Masters. Now, if I explained it and you're still curious about anything, let's talk about it in the comment section below. Like always, I answer all comments, so let's chat it up down there. If this video helped you out, please give it a like. It does help me out as far as putting this video into the recommendation tabs for others who may need help. And if you enjoy Pokemon Masters and want to see more content on Pokemon Masters, hit that subscribe button. I'm going to be doing a ton of Pokemon Masters content. I'm enjoying the game very, very much, especially leading up to Pokemon Sword and Shield. I'm also going to be doing videos on Pokemon Sword and Shield. So again, hit that subscribe button. I'm on the road to 1K, so please help me out on getting there. And that's going to be it for this video. Peace. I'll see you guys in the comments. I love you. I'm gonna see you guys on the next video. Like always, guys, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on Instagram and Twitter, and you guys can bring the conversation there. I'm the American Gamer in Switzerland right here on YouTube, and yes, I'm gonna be doing a ton of videos just like this one. So if you enjoy, please hit that subscribe button. Also hit the like button. It does help me out a ton as far as growing the channel is concerned. Ring the bell if you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video. Peace. I'm gonna see you guys on the next one.